Hallo, welkom hier bij Farmbook. Oké, okay, Nampo 2019, vrijdag. Nog een lekker stijve programma wat voorlê. Oké, okay, ek is hier bij Rocket Farm. Nou, wat doen hulle? Julle sal nie glo nie, telplanten, soos die milletjies net opgekom het met drones, wat nogal baie indrukwekkend is, maar dan meer indrukwekkend is dit. Hulle kan actually kyk na jou onkruide en onderskei, en hoe groot jou onkruidprobleem is en al die lekker nommers. So ek gaan met Chris praat, hy gaat my verduidelik hoe werk al hierdie goeders en wat is die lekker dinge waarmee hulle bezig is. So, ja, Chris, how are you?
Ben je saaf, André?
No, very, very good. Krijg maar zo voor mijn hakplekje daar zo.
Ja, okay.
Okay, so quickly explain to me Rocket Farm. What do you guys do?
So, André, Rocket Farm is a drone company specializing in high precision remote sensing applications for farmers. Well, ideally, or farming at, farming sort of sites. We, our main big customers are guys like the Bears and the Pioneers of this world as well, who are using us to really get centimeter level monitoring using drone technology of their farms as well. So very exciting stuff.
And specifically on the trials that they do and so forth.
Yes. So what you generally find is our customers are, you want to get 3 centimeters. You want to be able to get your yield right down to the centimeter as well of what you're getting per plot as well. So for them, it's critically important.
And tell me, do you then monitor, you were just speaking about the specifically the plant population and so forth for them, for these guys?
Yes.
How do you do that?
So so we have the 3 big customers for us, André. So the first one is obviously on the seeders and the breeders, right? And generally for them is they go through a couple of phases, right? Their first requirements, what they're looking at is number one is the plant counting. How is the trial going? What is the success of the planting of the trial as well? And from there on, so the idea is that we come and we fly and we immediately produce the infield reports, right?
Now, how long na die tyd gee hulle hulle daai report?
Literally in 30 minute. So
30 minutes.
In 30 minutes we take about 1 hour to fly about 100 hectares. We can then land, and in 30 minutes you have your first report already to the agronomist, and we can go do the ground truthing in field.
Dit is all right, nee.
Yeah.
En sê vir my, okay, maar nou het jy vir my ander ding ook verduidelik. Waar is hy telefoon vir jou? Jy my daai prentjie wys.
Yes.
Okay, so so what you did for that one customer in terms of satellite view?
So André, a lot of the guys, and I understand from a farmer's perspective, you're getting the satellite data for free, and I fully understand that. And this is, sort of the resolution that you're getting out of the data, right? A customer, this is a particular soya farm that a customer came to us and said, look, I've got a problem here. I can see I'm getting this NDVI data. Tell me what else I need to, where do I need to focus? So we then came with a drone and we flew, and this is the kind of the resolutions that you now get out of a drone data, right? It's, you can really start kind of zooming right in there, and you're getting the precision level. Now, that once you get this data from us, you can then export this into your, you can create prescription maps and spraying maps with this as well, and then export it straight into your sprayers or your John Deere equipment.
You can actually use that. But I mean, that is in very, very rare instances on grains where I would basically use that.
Yes.
But then you showed me something else which was really interesting.
Yes.
So show me that, how did you manage to identify, or just explain the problem. What was the onkruid wat ingekom het?
So again, with a lot of our customers, to do the plant counting, we are able to use an algorithm which actually looks at the leaf of the plant and able to count. At the same time, we can use the same algorithm to determine the difference if you're looking at a corn leaf or a cotton leaf and saying, well, everything that's not cotton or corn must be a weed then in this particular field of pivot. So we did a particular trial once with a customer here as well, where we were able to draw this heat map to say what is the difference between the cotton and what is the difference between weeds as well. So this is where we
and this focus. Is for a specific weed.
Yes, so this is a Palma amaranthus weed type that we went into, and we actually were able to identify the difference in the leaf species between the cotton and the leaf, and we're able to draw this heat map as well, and actually give an actual percentage and location. The great thing is
what's the percentage of that weed then in the land?
So we actually came back to this particular customer, and it ended up being at about 7% of their field, had an invasive weed species in it. But the beauty of this heat map is it's not just a picture, it comes with the GPS coordinates again, which we can export and you can take to your sprayers as well.
And you can actually go and apply that.
Correct, right.
Okay, so, but obviously your main market isn't the farmers directly.
Yes.
Where do you play and what is the value offerings that you have got for companies?
Yeah, so Andre, so we have the three customers as well. Again, not only just on the breeders' side, but our other two big customers is on the credit and the bank providers who really want to do the monitoring of their of their fields or of their investments as well. That's quite a big market for us. And then obviously on the insurance side, again, if there's any kind of hail damage or damage to the crops, we come out there, we fly 30 minutes, we have the data on your hand, we're able to draw and exactly indicate where the damaged crops are and pay out and do the assessment really quickly.
So a lot better would be like, want ek weet, okay, right, nou kom a hal deur.
Mm-hmm.
En die halstreep is gewoonlik iewers daar en nou stry ek in die ek en die taxeerder heeltyd oor luister die waar is die hal wat ook al en waar moet die ouens ingaan om te taxeer.
Correct.
So you can go fly over in 30 minutes.
Yes.
You can have an assessment of exactly where they need to go in to get a representative idea of what the damage should be.
I think another way to look at what our business is if you're sick, Andre, you're like, my cup is here or something, you're not so lucky, you're like, you go to the doctor, the doctor's like, listen, Andre, I need to send you for an x-ray because he can see something's not right, but he doesn't know if something's broken or maybe you just need a Panado. So he will then send you for an x-ray. We are like the x-ray for farming, for ag. We can tell you, give the precision to say, no, your shoulder's fine, it's not broken, it's a sprain, you're okay, take a Panado kind of thing. And that's really how you kind of apply what we do into the farming. We're not for everyone, but when you really need to know where the problem is, that's where we come in.
And if you, I know cost is always difficult on these things, but what would the duimsuig cost om trend wees? Van, sê, luister, ek kom vlieg die ding en ek geef jou die per hectare. What are you going to charge me?
You're looking at about $7,500 for half a day's work. So again, because we, for the sort of the draft dates as well, so about R7,500 for half a day. We can generally do about maybe between 100, 150 hectares in that half a day.
So you're not a per hectare charge, you're basically just the service. I come out, I sort it out, and this.
Remember, we're like your specialist doctor, right? The last thing you want to do is you want to go to someone and they're rushing you through. We're not like that. We're going to sit there with your agronomist on the field. We're going to fly. We're going to find the problems. We're going to go immediately with you to ground truth. He may then want to fly even a different section of the field, even more high precision, lower, closer as well. So we don't want to be, we're not the kind of company you're going to call us. We're not a McDonald's kind of product. You know what I mean? We're here for your gourmet service.
Is what I think. Okay, right. My problem with ek ook gewoonlik mee sit, ek spuit gif. Die gif werk nie. Of my persepsie is, die gif het nie gewerk nie.
Yes.
Kan julle dan uitkom en sê, okay, right, ons vlieg oor die land, en ons kan actually sien, but you know what, dit was, daar's 'n paar strepe wat nie gewerk het, it was actually the sprayer, or this is a field through problem, dit moet die gif gewees het, daar is nie ander idee nie, wat die rede waarvoor is een ander ding. Can you provide those types of services as well? Want dis 'n boerse oogpunt uit, as ek hy probleem met jy morgen daar, ek betaal jou, klap.
That's exactly what we'll specialize in. And again, that's why we charge the prices what we do, because we're not here to be in a rush. We want to take it slowly with you because we want to find your problem. We're not a fast food kind of company. So yes, we'll be there, but then you've got to bring your agronomist in and we will work with them to find the problem and to identify and give the exact accurate GPS location of where the problem is. No time wasting. And we go and we find it immediately.
En al is het vir my net om die versekering op te check, magtig, ek like die goed.
Dank je.
Okay, en dan die ander ding, die bankkant. Verduidelik my net gou so min of meer, wat is julle idee dan met die finansiële instansies enzovoort?
So, Andre, the really ideas behind the banking, the finance, or the co-ops, or finance from small-scale farming to large-scale, sometimes you need to provide the proof back to the banking and finance institution that you're spending the money, right? So a lot of our customers, the banks, the finance, would use it just from a monitoring perspective. What is the success of the crop? How's it looking? You know, do they need help? Do you need, any kinds of nitrogen applications? We're like an early warning system, I guess, for the banks. So, and it's, again, at the end of the day, the pictures don't lie. So if you need it, to prove to insurance over time or to the banks to even lower your risk, to give you better interest rates, to prove to the banks that that you're a responsible farmer. You know, I mean, we're one of those reports that they can use to do that as well, on top of the yield.
Awesome. Yeah. Chris,
thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, right. Sure. Wat denk ik? Ek dink as jy enige probleem het en jy sit met waar dit afhang van 'n subjektiewe gedeelte af, iemand se persepsie rondom het die gif gewerk, het die gif nie gewerk nie, waar is die halskade, waar is die halstreep deur, hoeveel daai tipe van dinge, soos hy sê, die prentjies lieg nie. Ek dink vir 7,500 nie, as jy 500,000 rand se eis het of 'n miljoen rand se eis het wat so gebeur, ek ben even ryp, daai tipe van goed, kry die goed, hulle vlieg, whatever, gaan kyk die prentjies, en dan jy voet om op te staan, om vir jy ons te kan sê, luister, hier so manier, hier so is julle bezig om uit die oore te werk, of, tenminste, kry jy die peace of mind, wat net sê, luister, ek maar weet wat die taxatie was, min of meer recht geweest. Ek dink daar is die grootste waarde in hierdie goed, financiering, hy goed, denk ek sal kom met tyd, en jy ons sal met het werk, maar ek dink versekering, so, boere, versekerings, die versekeringsmaatskappye, luister mooi, kyk die video, kontak die ouens, ek dink julle gaan nog goedkoper taksasies ook deurtrek, want jy vat baie van jou man ure weg, wat jy nie nodig het om aan ons te betaal nie. My ook persoonlike opinie, maar ja, dis net myne. So jy is hier van Nampo 2019, tot volgende keer. Groete!